All right, take a look at the top line. You can call them the top line. You can call them the second line. Either way, they're getting it done. The trio of Pacioretty, Stastny, and Stone combining for 12 of the 18 goals so far in this series. Look at this graphic right here. Trio of players with 8 or more points through the team's first 4 games of a playoff series going back to 1985. 28 points combined against San Jose, the most since 2006. Pacioretty, Stastny, and Stone. Just 6 points so far in this game number 4 win. But what is that chemistry like? And did it really start clicking once Mark Stone came over in that deal?
It did. It really started kicking. And once Max Pacioretty found himself and really was able to get his game in Vegas, because it's a different style of game, and they've wanted him to incorporate his style with their style, and now it's clicking because he's using his feet more. As I said, his best asset are his feet and his shot. And in Mark Stone, you get a guy that brings these guys into the game from a physical standpoint. Mark Stone's also great defensively, and he's a real well-rounded player, 200-foot guy. Stastny's a great distributor of the puck. So all things being equal, we talked to our statistician, Jonathan Barron, in the back, said that this trio has accounted for not only the 6 points tonight, KC, but 12 of the 18 goals for the Vegas Golden Knights on the series. If that's not domination, I don't know what is.
They've definitely taken the commanding lead for the Vegas Knights in this series. They've shut down the top line for the Sharks, and it's been fun to watch.
And they're doing it in different ways, too. This, we talked about it earlier tonight, too, that they're able to do it, again, off the rush, off the cycle, on the power play. Doesn't really matter. But, yeah, Jamie, your question to me about Mark Stone, he's been the difference maker for this team. I remember when they acquired him, I spoke to somebody in the organization. They said, now we're going to have everybody slotted in the right spots with the acquisition of Mark Stone.
Pacioretty, 4 points in the game 4 win. And how about Mark Stone, 10 points so far in this series.
Incredible.
That line getting it done. And if he's not getting it done, that line not getting it done, it's the guy in net who's definitely getting it done. And he has throughout his entire career, especially playoff time. Marc-Andre Fleury, 15th career playoff shutouts. What more can you say about this guy?
Love him.
Future Hall of Famer.
Hall of Famer, JMO, you named it. He's 4th all-time in playoff shutouts, 7th all-time passing Mike Vernon with most playoff wins. He's going to be down at Yonge and Front Street in Toronto at the place called the Hockey Hall of Fame when it's all done. But the thing about the Flower is he's so competitive in the crease. And you look at the greats that are on this board, him being one of them. And, I mean, this just speaks volumes for what he's been able to accomplish for this point. He's their most visible player. He's their superstar. But he's giving them all that they need. The goaltending has been a big advantage for them based on how well he's played so far this series. And that continues to inspire confidence in his teammates.
It does. And when the Sharks started to slide at the end of the regular season, they had to know that they were going to have to face him because of their poor efforts in the month of March.
Mm-hmm. And Marc-Andre Fleury, too, keep in mind, 2nd in the league in the regular season in shutouts. Mm-hmm. Sergei Bobrovsky was able to surpass it, but he had 8 on the regular season. Still in the Vezina Trophy conversation for me.
Are you seeing some frustration boiling over for the San Jose Sharks,
yes,
and specifically Evander Kane getting tossed from this one? If you're Ryan Reaves, you're smiling because you've done your job. You've gotten under one of the best players on the opposition at this point.
He did do his job, and you have to understand why Evander Kane is so frustrated. It's 4-0 in this moment. He's trying to get his team riled up. There was frustration before the game, and clearly, you know, Ryan Reaves got to him, and it was clearly a distraction for Kane. He let it boil over and take advantage of his moment in this game.
All right, we'll have to see if Evander Kane is available to play in game number 5. How about the Vegas Golden Knights?